Oh, welcome back, you bunch of weirdos, to this, the FIFA 17 Ajax Career Mode! And guys, this is your boy, B-Monus, broadcasting live from once again underneath a blanket in my parents' living room. Yes, it is, it's pretty great up here in San Francisco right now, but alas, gotta get into it. Into something that has just been draining, man. I have not been this torn over a transfer in a career mode on or off of YouTube. Ever. What the fuck do we do with Riechedly Bazoer, aka the Big Bad Bazoer? I mean, it's weird, because in real life, yeah, he's going to move, and I understand why he's going to move, because he wasn't getting the playing time. And if he's not going to get the playing time, then he should go somewhere where he is going to get the playing time. I just think it's weird that, hey, you're not going to get playing time here at Ajax in the Eredivisie, so go over to Wolfsburg, and they'll give you minutes in the Bundesliga. I mean, not to throw shade on either of the leagues, but as an American, I always assumed that, you know, the Bundesliga was a little bit more prestigious, that Wolfsburg was a bigger team. So this does definitely raise my eyebrows to where Ajax sits in the world footballing, you know, scheme, I guess, or in the ladder. But I had multiple votes, and it was really torn. You guys, it was pretty much like 55 to 45 to sell him. In the last episode, I did decide, and I did say that I was going to sell him. So now, it's the moment of truth. Alfred Duncan, we're not going to go with you, so we're just going to go down to either Brian Debo or Jefferson Lerma. And who is it, ladies and gentlemen? It is Jefferson Lerma. No, I faked you out. It's Brian Debo. No, I faked you out again. It isn't Brian Debo, which leaves. It is Jefferson Lerma, or is it? Yes, guys, I've decided I'm going to keep him. I know about half you, over half you guys, you know, wanted to sell him. But hey, over half of this country wanted Hillary Clinton as our president, and we got Donald Trump. So it's a little bit of a tough cookie. I do apologize to all you guys and to just drawing this out for so long. But when it came down to it, I realized that I am not, you know, the real life coach of Ajax. I gave this motherfucker minutes. I gave him all the minutes. Why should another team be reaping the rewards? Because I gave this man everything that he wanted. And if we go ahead and we take a look at him, he's content, man. He's happy to be here. He's getting the minutes, you know, in order to play for the national team, which is his dream. We're going to hold on to him. Let's not be, you know, the feeder team of Ajax old. Let's go ahead and let's freaking keep our talents, man, at least until we win some silverware. So, you know, I don't know how long we'll keep Bazoer after this transfer window. Maybe he'll go on the next one. But for now, we're keeping him at least till the end of the season. I hope you guys are okay with it. And even on top of that, we're going to try to make some transfers with a little bit of cheese. As you can see right here, I'm inquiring for a couple of these guys on the last day. Oh, a couple of you guys have also spoken about Yassin Ayoub from Utrecht to see about him. So we're doing the trick where on the final hour of transfer deadline day, you inquire about a whole bunch of people. And if you haven't done that, I'll go ahead and leave a link to that at the end of this video. There's this new trick that you can do in FIFA 17. You go ahead and advance it. And then you actually get the inquiries, and you have a month to actually complete those transfers in February. It's pretty ridiculous. And guys, Eduardo Rossi is finally old enough for us to bring the team. So I want you guys to go ahead and vote right now. 91 to 94 potential for the Brazilian wonderkind Rossi. Do we bring him into the side? He's rated 64 right now. Or do we let him simmer? Do we let him slow cook a little bit? Develop a little bit more juiciness and flavors in the Toekomst? Or do we bring him into the first team? Let your opinions be known, and let me assure you that this vote, it will be definitive. As we do go ahead and bring in a couple of others, this is what I'm talking about. We'd have been stuck with Lassie Shona over here, and he's the one talking about, like, oh, I'm not getting enough playtime. We gave us so much playtime. He's happy. But we're going to go in for a couple other big-name players. Well, not big-name, but, you know, sensible players. Jeremiah St. Justy, or Hoost, Joost, as I believe, what's the correct pronunciation? Go ahead and help me out. We're going to trade out Dinks over here, because we just never use him. I know that some people like him, some people don't like him, but we just never use him in this side. It's gonna be the same way with Jordan Lukaku. I kind of favor like taller fullbacks in the back three, just because they're faster and tend to be a little bit, you know, more higher agility, and that's what you need in the back three. You need really high agility, high athletic people in the back to actually cover all that space. And we're also going in for Mione Sisto or for Younes, because Younes, I don't know. I've used him a couple times, and he just doesn't seem like my kind of guy. In this episode, since we are on the transfer window, we're going to cut it a little bit shorter. Only two matches. There's one up against Go Eagles, and Hercules. I don't know if that's a Dutch pronunciation, but that's how you pronounce it in American English. In the next episode, get your titties wet, because we got Feyenoord coming up, and Napoli in, I believe, the Champions League first leg. All right. Up with the usual suspects up in here. Bailey, Dolberg, Adamilson up in the front top. Bazoer back into the side after clearing it away. I've spoken with him personally, and he is fine. And Danny staying in this side. Riedewald, no Sanchez. Fierhaver going ahead and getting the start because Sanchez was a little bit tired from the previous match up against Hercules Almelo, I believe is what you're saying. Now, Hercules, much like their namesake, used to be good back in ancient times. They've won two Eredivisie titles, well, two national titles, but haven't done all too much since. They've been kind of relegated, then coming back in. Well, you know, they're kind of a lower to mid-table side. As you can see, most of our usual suspects are in this lineup. We're rocking with the four. No, I don't want to talk about 3-4-3. Systems and Donker. And got a Team of the Week card not too long ago. Now that's... How many players on the team has actually gotten it? Bailey got a team at the tournament for freaking Euro, or was it UEFA? For he got like one of the Frosty, one of the blue cards, and Doctor's got one, and Dolberg has gotten one so far. So out on the lookout. Let's see who else can get it. Lovely little flick from there. Ziyech in. Klaassen, can he find? Oh, tepid shot right at Castro right there. But it was mostly Ajax early on. 8 minutes in. Good stuff. Dolberg taking a shot from distance. Oh, if that would have got it. The scenes. Castro, come on, just let it in. And Dolberg-san from distance. I thought once that left his boot, it was like, oh, that felt good. That felt great. But amazing save, amazing save. Now Ziyech into the middle. Gets it flipped away, but then Fierhaver coming in for Sanchez, dinking it off of the post. And then Bazoer over to Dolberg. And oh, there's that low composure. That's that low composure coming in. Now, Adamilson, nothing's really going to happen here. A little bit of spoiler. But look, this is why he's starting over Traore. Absolutely rinsing, carving through defenders. Everyone leaving destruction in his wake. Doesn't actually lead to anything. Once again, I don't want to get your hopes up right there, but just showing you the agility and the pace and the speed and the strength. Basically, everything that boy has got in his locker, that is why he's starting over Bertrand Traore, just taking it from, you know, end to end. Now to Donker, over to Ziyech. Ziyech goes ahead, hits Bailey on the overlap. Does he spot anyone into the middle? To Ziyech again! And once again, we only find Crossbar. Woodwork was the top goalie of the day. And then we take a terrible angle. The tackle is left wanting. Here comes Hercules. Can they show us the ancient Greek strength? Klaassen gets onto it. And then a little bit pushed wide. But then it would be more of Hercules coming into the middle right here. Lucky little bounce. Fierhaver able to get it away. Klaassen over to the top but cannot get onto it. Brinks knocks it down. Back into it. And look at this ticky-tacky bullshit. All of a sudden, Hercules just magically turns into Barcelona. What a fucking goal. What a fucking team goal. Look at the vision. Pulling it into the middle. That's only a goal that Barcelona, Real Madrid, and the CPU in FIFA can score. Because there's nothing I could do. I literally like could click over maybe once or twice to switch the person, but there's when the CPU wants to score, they can score. Unless we have to go ahead and chase the game. We got a couple of fresh legs in here. Traore in for Adamilson. Can he put it away? Closing it into the middle. Finds Ziyech. Tries to do the Karate Kid. But he is no Mr. Miyagi. Wax on, wax off, no mas. For the Moroccan man. Not for sure that he would put this in on his preferred left foot. But going wanting a little bit past the post. Adamilson still into this game. Gets taken down by Dari. And should have been two there. But the header going a little bit far wide. 86 minute, would we be knocked out? I forgot to mention, this is in the Orange Cup or the Dutch Cup in real life. And it looks like we might have to be going down 89th minute though. Adamilson still into the game. Goes ahead, flips it into the middle. And who's there? It is him! It is him! Oh, Isak, one of the other substitutions, him and Traore. One of three substitutions coming in late. Dolberg ineffective in this match. And of course, we have to rely on a now possibly super sub of a man. Alexander Isak putting it back into the sack. Oh, Lovely stuff for getting his first goal. Great time to get his first goal in the Orange Cup there, young lad. And the 16-year-old continues to impress beyond his years, saving us with an 89th-minute last gasper, and we're going into extra time, lads. Can we carry this momentum? Isak going ahead, linking up the Ajax boys. Patient build-up play early on in extra time. Osadebe finding Bazoer, and Adam Wilson spots it for Trantor. Unmarked, cutting inside. Easy as you like. And there you go. He hasn't been doing too much. He hasn't done too much since the beginning of the season, but scores an absolutely sensationally crucial goal for us right there. The Ajax fans going absolutely nuts, keeping our hopes alive from death's doorstep. We rescue this. Easily could have gone out in this tournament mere minutes ago. All of a sudden, role reversal. And as a couple of you guys have been saying, hey man, you can see too much in the 4-3-3. You know, in 3-4-3. Later in this match, I'm going to go ahead, put it on more defensive right here, moving it into a 3-5-2 formation. Hopefully you guys appreciate that. I am listening to y'all. But unfortunately, I wasn't really super used to this formation, and it kind of gave more opportunity to the other side, just because I just didn't know where the passing lanes were, and I had to, you know, kind of was given the ball up in possession in the midfield. So it's something that I definitely need to practice a little bit more on. Maybe in the, you know, the lower tier games or games that don't mean as much. Now Kiwas going ahead and linking up. Oh no, not good hands right there. Getting one of the fair saves. And this is what I was talking about. Losing in the midfield just because I didn't know where the next pass was going. Getting another chance, and unlucky bounces off of the post. Really, really lucky stuff right there. And that is not where I wanted to put the ball in, but Onana comes and collects with those strong hands of his wrists, and then going ahead, getting inside. Bazoer gets taken. How is that not a penalty, ref? On what freaking planet? Are we playing on Mars? Are we on Jupiter right now? Because that is diabolical. Now, it's going to lead to a penalty. If that would have led to a counterattack goal, I would have just quit FIFA. I would have just logged off of YouTube and been like, delete channel. And as you can see right here, flipping it into the middle, we see that the keeper is on the line, but unfortunately, no chance to try anything for long and nothing too cute. Kiwas trips over his own player. And no, not like this EA. Not like this. Flipping into the middle. Fear hover. Oh, risky stuff. Osadebe gets closed down, but it is not enough. And Hercules goes ahead and puts up a monumental, just historical effort up against us, man. Something to be proud of, but unfortunately, they were still half mortal in this one. We fell them late in the 90th minute. Oh, 290, well, not 290 plus, an 89th minute equalizer, and then we push on to go ahead and get the winner. Tenacious stuff. Absolutely great stuff. This is what champions are made of, man. To come back, to have that spirit, to have that determination and strength of mind in order to get back in this very even match, man. Distribution, possession was pretty much evenly matched in this one. But we go ahead. We had the better quality, and eventually we won out. That is what I like to see. And now we're going back into the Eredivisie. PSV and Fire Nord all tied up at 47 apiece. We have a 7-point lead with all games tied up. Whew. This is kind of interesting, though. They both have 14 points, but one of them has, like, 2 losses, and the other one has 4 losses, so it's kind of interesting. Right there, Celta Vigo won a little bit more for Yunus, but we just do not have the cash. We did not sell enough players, so Yunus and 1 million more is probably going to be our final bid for Pione Sisto over here. We're going to go ahead and advance a little bit. Ooh, but Hunenvine goes ahead and says that it is good enough. We can go ahead and start bargaining for Jeremiah St. Just. I think he would be perfect for our back three. He has the athleticism, he's got the speed, and he's got enough strength and, you know, technical cleverness to be a good defensive stalwart in our back line. Dolbergson leading the Eredivisie with 14 goals, 2 ahead of Jorgensen of Feyenoord. Also, you know, as we see right here, Dolberg also the top in assists. Unfortunately, that's because we had to trade out both Klaassen and Ziyech over there. Otherwise, they'd probably be up there, but... you know, EA is something. Merry Christmas to everybody. By the way, I'm recording this on my birthday, so if you could, show me who the true weirdos in this. If you're still watching this, go ahead, leave a happy birthday Nathan or happy birthday Bimonis down in the comments down below. It would be highly appreciated. And I thought, you know, we got a 7-point lead in the Eredivisie. Why not go ahead and start a lot of our youngsters? up in this biznatch over here. As you can see, Cherny, Mbappe, Lawton, Traore, actually not going to get the start. We're going to trade out Isak. He earned it with the game-saving, tournament-saving goal he got late in the last match. So there we go. Amsterdam Arena, we are back at home. Can we get something going on right now? Ajax, 53 points, sitting on top of Go Eagles. Go Eagles, historically, they're kind of like, how should I put them? They're kind of like Hull. They kind of float in, they kind of float back, or maybe like a West Brom of the Eredivisie. And they actually were very famously, they kept Ajax from getting a perfect season back in 2013. So can they fail us once more in this one? Can they play spoiler? It's going to be up to this. It's going to be an interesting one right here. All right, as we go ahead and we kick off things early on, interesting stuff going ahead. A little bit too hard from Isak. You know, that's all he does is just he hits balls hard. Yeah, some guys like that. Some guys not so much. Most ladies, if you're listening, all one of you, most guys don't like their balls hit hard. Just saying, but some do. And if they do, marry that man. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and link up. Nori from distance finds Woodwork once again. And that would be the man. Watch that little dynamo in the midfield. Nori was absolutely a legend in this match. Much, much touted. A lot of people saying that he is the next, you know, he's going to be the next big thing over at Ajax. And he got the start in this one, and he was on one. Look at that. First, he finds Woodwork, then forcing a full, outstretched save from the keeper. Now Shona into the middle, gets onto it. Ugh. Maybe could have found a little bit more danger. Now Nori, the danger man in this one, goes ahead, sees Cherny on the overlap, getting it back into Nori. Nori plays a 1-2 with Isak. Isak, beautifully weighted ball, and Nori is somehow slithering RKO out of nowhere. How did he get that? How did he get to that ball first? Usually that's always cut out from the defender, but Nori, acceleration kills in this freaking match. Delightful, some frightening acceleration from the Dutch Moroccan. I think he's of Moroccan descent. And go ahead, guys, after this episode, I will be going back to LA after the holidays, and I will be profiling. So let's go ahead and bring back the vote. I highly suggest we go ahead and profile Nori. You guys like the, you know, the Big Bad Bazoer and Bailey, the Usain Bolt, but look at this man. Look at him. Absolutely. Oh my God, I've never seen that intricate enough, like Spider-Man-esque, weaving his way, using his high agility, using his spider sense to carve his way around defenders, and they have no choice but, oh, Sander Fischer put into a pickle, hook, line, and sinker, and he is the catch of the day as he goes ahead and gets the showers. Get wet, my son, get wet, my son. Nori is the one who earned it. He is going to be the one to take the pen. 34 steps up, calm, cool as you like. It was his match, man. It was his match. Do a little booty dance. You deserve it. Get in there, Sanchez. Get in there. Oh, no. That was Isak. Racism on me. Oh. But good stuff. Good stuff. Abdelhak Nori. Delightful stuff, man. I got to play him more. A lot of you Ajax truthers. You Ajax truthers have been telling me, man. He is the one. He is the next show's one. And a great save. We're going to play the Oh Nana music just because I don't have any music for Svilar over there. But good save from him. He had a little bit of disappointing match in his previous previous game, but ever since then he's been good. Isak getting a little bit closed down. If there is one weakness, he doesn't have, you know, the paciest of the mofoiest right there. Mbappe Lawton trying to switch it into the middle, and Zfuk's just gonna go ahead. Oh, that's right, we went ahead and we transferred him out, playing up against his old team right there. But he's gonna have to stomach this 2-0 loss. Good stuff. You know, not all too much from a lot of the Ajax players. Good defensive effort, but, you know, it was Nori's match. It was his time to shine, and that's what I like to see, man. Developing youth. We have two outrageously talented young... Well, we just have an embarrassment of riches. Pirates bounty's worth of talented youngsters, man. And even though, like, ZX is dynamic, he is our talisman. But if he were ever to move on, it's good to know that young Nori's on. I mean, just look at him. He was doing stuff that I've never seen people do usually in FIFA. Just cutting, carving, Spider-Maning, doing a little bit of the stanky leg. It was outrageous. But anyway, guys, hopefully you did enjoy. Hopefully you guys are okay with Bazoer. How do you feel about the Bazoer transfer? Did you think we should have transferred him? I'll go ahead and leave a poll up to that right now. Remember to go ahead and vote in which player that we should be profiling. And we are going to... press conferences are here. They're still here to stay. It's just I've been away and I have been able to record them while I'm up here in SF. So please leave your PCQs down below. Anyway, guys, happy holidays. Go ahead and check out the video I described on how to sign players outside of the transfer window. Go ahead, get caught up on the latest and greatest of, check out the last episode of the Ajax Career. My name is Bimanis. Hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Remember to stay yourself, stay humble, and be aware. All right, let's get out underneath this blanket. Ugh, it's hot.